Byron Bay has been ravaged by king tides that swallowed the coastline today, bringing down trees and infrastructure. Communities right across the state's north battled another day of flash flooding, and the Bureau says the extreme weather event is far from over.
We know the ocean is powerful, and today it showed us once again. A king tide took on trees and won. At Clark's Beach in Byron Bay, a man tried to get a photo on a walkway that was closed and it collapsed.
Oh my God!
Still clutching his phone and apparently not hurt, he climbed back up, but the debris left behind was substantial. A cafe perched on top of these sand dunes was tested, but a line of defence put in place a month ago saved the day.
We're witnessing Mother Nature put on a hell of a show. Fortunately, we're in a very protected corner of the beach. Then the east-facing beaches are taking a real hammering.
Byron's iconic main beach disappeared this morning as the waves joined the road and washed cars in the car park.
I've been here for 15 years and it's disintegrating. And to see it coming up over the car park, I don't even think we're safe standing here. The worst I've ever seen it, and it's not looking good.
We came here thinking it would be really nice and sunny, but yeah, it's big waves.
The sea is so close to this car park now. The water's actually lapping over the top of this and coming in and drenching these vehicles either side of us, which is extraordinary.
Locals say the beach erosion has been getting worse over the past few months.
I've been sad about it for a while, and this is just the latest instalment of what's going on.
There seems to be more damage and progressively more and more trees and more of the dune being eaten away.
The king tide that washed away this amount of the beach was more than 20% larger than the normal peak for this time of year. Tomorrow's tide is forecast to be even bigger, but the Bureau says the swell won't be as ferocious.
You know, we'll get through it and we'll rebound like Mother Nature will let our beaches do as well. But right now, it's a pretty painful experience to witness.
It was another wet day for residents right up and down the north coast. And despite only a handful of flood rescues, some were still willing to chance it. Homeowners at Ballina woke to water lapping at their doorsteps. While further north at Tumbulgum, the car park resembled a lake. Roads have been closed and small communities cut off from each other. The Weather Bureau says the event has been like a cyclone.
Some sites on the Northern Rivers District have seen around about 400 millimetres in just the last couple of days, and there's more rain to come.
Hannah Sinclair joins us now from Coolangatta. And Hannah, there's a bizarre spectacle where you are tonight.
Yes, Georgie, just when we thought we'd seen it all from this weather event, we've now got seafoam here at Snapper Rocks at Coolangatta. The kids out here have been playing in it for several hours now. I've never seen anything like this before. It's said to be safe. It's the ocean's particles all mixed together because of the storm. So this has been churned up in the swell that we've been seeing. No idea how long it's going to stick around for. I gather the rain will be a factor in that to see if it gets washed away. But certainly seen a lot on our beaches today, and this is just another sight to behold.
Extraordinary scenes indeed, Hannah. Thank you.